Happy New Year, friends. I hope you had a wonderful holiday season and welcome to 2024. This is our first seed haul video of the year of 2024. And today we're gonna be doing Baker Creek seeds. So I hope you had a wonderful, healthy, happy holiday season. Thanks for your patience while we've been away. We went up to Lake Tahoe with some friends for the new year for about 5 days and enjoyed ourselves, and we just got home last night. I still need to take down all of my holiday decorations. Really want to do that. But I thought I would get out a seed video for you guys because I'm really looking forward to starting seeds, which will be happening this week. Not a ton of seeds this week. Next week, even more. Basically, just every week, there's gonna be more and more seeds starting. And all of that is based on when my last frost date is, which in our area is listed as February 15th, but in the last 4 years, it's been as late as April. So I'm doing this anyway. I'm gonna go on the schedule that I have set based on my microclimate. So about mid-April, I'm assuming as my last frost date, because that's what it's been. And I'm setting up first today for veggies. So Baker Creek is great. Their seed packets have photos on them, so I'll be able to show you everything that I'm gonna be sowing. The first, we're going to start with, I'm going in alphabetical order for veggies here. This one was a free seed, but I can always use more basil. This is just Genovese basil, 68 days, which is great. But this is a very tender annual, so I won't be putting any of this out until after frost for sure. Okay, so next we have beets. And most of my beet seeds had kind of expired, so I got some new ones. And I love golden beets. And so this one is an heirloom, goes back to the 1820s. And I'm really looking forward to trying to grow it. All right, some carrots. I've already got carrots growing in the garden right now, but and I have other packets of carrots that you'll see in other seed hauls, but for Baker Creek, this one is the Lila Lusang. It's a 75-day carrot, but look how gorgeous that is. Looking forward to trying that one. So corn, this one, Martian Jewels. I think I have this in other company seeds as well, but I'm really excited to try this one because it can be harvested immediately as a sweet corn, or you can let it stay for longer and harvest it as a dent corn or like a flower corn. So I'm actually really excited to try this year. Cucumbers. This one is an old favorite, Beet Alpha. It's really popular because it's so easy to grow and it's really prolific. And then this one I also tried last year, which they got eaten by rodents, but dragon's egg cucumbers. So I'm gonna try it again this year. And another cucumber here, China Jade. So that's it for my cucumbers. Then I have another, actually I have two free lettuce seeds here. This one is Merlot, that gorgeous lettuce. It's only 55 days, that's a really short lettuce. Also, Landis winter lettuce. So it's very cold hardy. So this one I'm gonna start very soon. I'm just gonna direct sow it actually out in the garden. And then because I've been enjoying the giant mustard that I popped in the garden that I got from a local nursery, I went on and bought some more seed for that. This is Japanese giant red. That mustard is so delicious, so spicy, and literally nothing wants to eat it, which is great. Okay, moving on to peppers. Craig's Grande Jalapeno, love this pepper. I use it to make cowboy candy every year. Now I am overwintering one of these already, plants, and I have a couple other different pepper plants that I'm overwintering in the greenhouse, hoping that they'll do well and come back. They look great, they look fine. They're dormant, but they're still green, they're still alive. So, and the coldest it's gotten in the greenhouse so far this year is 38 degrees Fahrenheit. So no freezing temperatures in there. I think they're gonna be okay. Now, this I'm super excited about. I've heard about these peppers from a couple of different homesteader videos that I watch on YouTube, and this is the first time I've been able to find the seeds for them, so I'm really excited to grow them. These are cachucha, so 85 to 100 days, and it's a Caribbean and Latin American popular pepper, so I'm really looking forward to growing these. All right, radishes. I have gone through all my radish seeds. This is a big packet of seeds, and it's a Easter basket mix. So what I'm going to do is I direct sow my radishes, so I'm going to direct sow some of them, but I'm also going to sow some in a tray for greens, for microgreens. Radish greens are edible, but when they get bigger, when the radish bulbs and the greens are there, you can still eat them, but I find them very spiny and pokey, so I like them as microgreens because they're tender and there's none of those spines. All right, zucchinis. So like I said, I have other, we'll be doing a botanical interest video for you and a Johnny's video for you. So there'll be other vegetables and flowers in those, so there will definitely be a lot more squashes because I love squash so much, winter and summer. This is a golden squash zucchini. Zucchini is super prolific, so I'm sure these will do really well. I usually only have two plants and it's more than we need. Now this one I tried last year and did not have any luck with it, but I didn't have any luck with any of my winter squashes last year. We had such an extended cold season in 2023 that things just really struggled. It was very strange winter. This winter is strange too because it's been extremely warm and we've hardly had any precipitation compared to last couple years. So yeah, it's weird. It's an El Nino year. We thought we were going to get tons of rain. Now today is January 3rd, and generally our rainiest period is January and February. So hopefully the Sierras will start packing in lots of snow, mostly because that's where our water comes from.
It's okay. It's okay, honey.
She's dragging her toy string to me. We've been gone for 5 days. She misses us so much when we're gone. And she's been attached to my side since we got home. So she just, that noise was her dragging her little string in because she wants me to play with her. Also, that particular string, they're all hoodie strings. They're like her favorite toys. Hoodie strings and paper balls are her favorite toys. Even though we buy her actual toys, those things are more her favorite. But that particular one was just in the front of the house next to her food bowl. So she drug it all through the house meowing like that. So after we finish with this video, I'll be giving her a lot of playtime. All right, so this is Seminole squash. This is a wild squash of the Everglades in Florida. It takes heat, humidity, and pests very well, and it's very sweet. I'm so excited to grow this. I mostly grew up in Florida, and I never knew this existed. Squash, of course, cucurbits are New World plants. And so, it's not surprising that the Everglades area would have its own, but I'm very much looking forward to trying this out. Okay, another zucchini. This one is Rompicanti. It's a very curved Italian heirloom squash. So supposedly very tender and mild. All right, and then a tomato before we move into flowers. This one is brown sugar. And if you have gotten the Baker Creek catalog, you will have seen this. I think it's on the cover. This is a new one for this year. It's indeterminate and it's a Russian heirloom with smoky complex flavor. So looking forward to that. All right. So now moving on to flowers. What's up, baby girl? Now moving on to flowers for the Baker Creek. I've already grown these a number of times and I love them and I need to add them to the new farm. I just want to pepper the place with them because they're so great for pollinators, and you can make tea out of them. I cut them for bouquets. They smell amazing. So I have a variety here I'm going to grow. This is Apache Sunset, Agastache. It's root beer scented flowers. And then I have a mix here of Agastache. It's Fragrant Delight. they're so pretty. And like I said, pollinators love them. They have those tubular flowers. So the butterflies and the hummingbirds, everybody who needs, who has a proboscis, long tongue, they can get into these flowers and get what they want. Okay, so I have some calendula seeds, which I haven't bought calendula seeds in ages because I don't tend to grow a lot of it anymore. Calendula is beautiful and it's wonderful for lots of different things, for cut flowers and for making salves and all kinds of stuff like that and dried flowers, and it's a great dye. But I find it very sticky, the stems and stuff, so I don't tend to use it as a cut flower that much, but they're just so pretty. And again, wonderful for pollinators. And here in my zone, they're actually perennial. So I wanna put a bunch out at the farm, and doing it by seed is the cheapest way to do that. So this one is the Playtime Mix, and you can see how many pretty colors are in there. And then I have one called Pink Surprise. Okay, this one is a dandelion. You're like, why on earth would you get dandelion seeds and grow dandelions? Well, these don't spread that much. And these are a really cool varieties. This one is a pink one. I've grown this before. It's a perennial wildflower from Central Asia. And it's much less prolific. In other words, where you plant it, it really doesn't spread. So I had this out at Fish Ranch and it really just did not spread, which was really cool. And then I also have these, Japanese, not considered aggressive or weedy. It's a white one, really pretty. Okay, and then I got some 4 o'clocks. I have never grown these. These are an old heirloom favorite, kind of like sweet peas. It's a tender perennial. So yellows, reds, and oranges. They're striped, so they're really pretty. These I'm gonna direct sow. And then I have Didiscus. I tried growing this last year, it got eaten, so I'm gonna try again. I have a white variety as well. This one is lace pink. Now it's 100 days, so it takes a while. That's over 3 months before this will come up. And then Mullein. Now this, we have native variety here in California, but this one is so pretty. It's verbascum. It's perennial in zones 5 through 8. It'll probably still do okay here in our zone 9, but look at those colors. They're super drought tolerant. It's also called the toilet paper plant because if you've ever felt the leaves of Mullein, they're soft and velvety. I used it medicinally when we all had COVID. I boiled up tea with the leaves and we drank that and it really helps. It's in mucilage, so it really helps the lungs in functioning, and also we were able to get some of that phlegm out of there. So yeah, it's a beautiful plant and it's highly useful. And then Nicotiana. These are called the marshmallow variety, perennial in zones 8 through 10. And it's an annual in much cooler zones, but they're so, so pretty. I can use them for cuts. And yeah, I thought it would be fun to grow. And then the final flower is more Rudbeckia. So I have, and there's not very many seeds in here. Again, Rudbeckia, I love this flower. It comes in lots of different colors in the yellow, orange, brown, red shades. I really love them, but they tend to be a little prickly. I grow them more as perennials for pollinators and for beauty in my garden. So I'm gonna put a bunch of these out at the farm as well. This is Caramel. It's an 85 day one, so it's a really smoky set of colors, kind of vintagey. And these grow to 19 inches tall, so it should be fairly long stems. There's not a ton of seeds in here. There's 40 seeds in this packet, but you know, if all of them germinated and I planted them all out and they all survived, that's 40 Rudbeckia plants, that's a lot. So I don't think I'll need that much more. So that is my Baker Creek seed haul. Not as big as it's been in the past, but I still have a lot of seeds left over from previous years. Some seeds last for a really long time. Others, you know, kind of fizzle out after the first year or so. So you really need to, you know, kind of keep refreshing your seeds. But I will not lie to you. I'm definitely a seed hoarder, just like I have a yarn stash that never ends, even though I can only knit so much. So, you know, everybody collects something. For me, it's plants and seeds and yarn. So, you know, guilty as charged. So that's going to be it for me today. I hope you are starting to make your seed orders. A few of the seed companies, including Johnny's, have said that they are expecting shortages this year. So if you haven't placed a seed order yet, I would get on that pretty quickly. It's not like there'll be none available, but the varieties that you like are going to disappear quicker. And so I would order sooner rather than later. And there's a lot of seeds, no matter what your zone is, that you can start even now indoors. So thanks so much for joining me. I hope you have a wonderful time in your garden or in your garage starting seeds or wherever you do that. And I will see you in the next one. Bye.